Vasodilatory shock is a life-threatening syndrome that requires immediate treatment to maintain adequate mean arterial pressure and organ perfusion. If intravenous fluid resuscitation fails to increase the blood pressure, vasopressors such as catecholamines and vasopressin are used. However, these drugs have a narrow therapeutic window and toxicities at high doses. Adding angiotensin II, a hormone that is a component of the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, to catecholamine and vasopressin therapy may increase arterial pressure. In the international double-blind ATHOS III trial, 344 patients with catecholamine-resistant vasodilatory shock requiring norepinephrine or other vasopressors were randomized to receive a titrated intravenous infusion of angiotensin II or placebo. The primary endpoint was the mean arterial pressure response at hour 3 after the start of the infusion, defined as an increase from baseline of 10 millimeters of mercury or more, or an increase to at least 75 millimeters of mercury. 69.9% of those in the angiotensin II group achieved the primary endpoint, as compared with 23.4% in the placebo group, a difference that was statistically significant. Serious adverse events, which included multi-organ failure, cardiac arrest, and respiratory failure, were reported in 60.7% of the patients in the angiotensin II group and 67.1% of those in the placebo group. Death by day 28 occurred in 46% of the angiotensin II group, as compared with 54% of the placebo group. That difference was not statistically significant. The authors conclude that angiotensin II effectively increased blood pressure in patients with vasodilatory shock that was not responsive to high doses of conventional vasopressors. Full trial results are available at NEJM.org.